नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। इस समय हमारे साथ उपस्थित सभी दर्शकों और भक्तों का मैं प्रेम एवं आशीर्वाद सहित स्वागत करता हूँ। आई वेलकम ऑल द डिवोटीज, डिसाइपल्स, समाजीज, सत्संगीज सिटिंग विद अस ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड थ्रू नित्यानंद टीवी, लोटस टीवी, साधना टीवी एंड टू वे वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग। City is sitting with us in two-way video conferencing, having Nayana Diksha all over the world, Los Angeles, Kuala Lumpur Palani, Enriching Temple Bidhi, Oklahoma Somanatham, Guadalupe Rameshwaram, Houston Kalahasti, Washington DC Sripuram, Toronto Kailasam, Ohio Prayag, Charlotte Srisailam, पेरिस कालीघाट, सियाटल चिदंबरम, सिंगापुर सिंगापुरम, ओक्लाहोमा सोमनाथम, वैंकूवर भुवनेश्वर, सैन होसे मदुरई, डैलस द्वारका, देवोन यूके, न्यूयॉर्क वाराणसी, काठमांडू नेपाल, स्लोवाकिया शिवलोका, तिरुवान्मियूर चेन्नई, ऑस्टिन, ह्यूस्टन कालाहस्ती, हांगकांग सिरगाड़ी, हैदराबाद गुप्तकाशी, पोर्ट वाशिंगटन न्यूयॉर्क, मिल वैली वैरवन गोयल, सैन डियागो तिरुआलबाई, दुबई वैद्यनाथम, ईस्ट लंदन यूके, न्यूयॉर्क वाराणसी, देवोन यूके, नेदरलैंड्स, फिलाडेल्फिया, स्लोवाकिया शिवलोका, काठमांडू नेपाल, ओमन शिवगंगई, दैट्स इट। आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू विथ माय लव एंड ब्लेसिंग्स। टुडे इज 960th नित्य सत्संग, एक्सक्लूडिंग ऑल द सत्संग्स आई डिलीवर्ड बिफोर 2010 एंड ईवनिंग सत्संग्स। 20th batch Inner Awakening 4th day, 17th batch Ingenious 4th day, 19th batch Nirahara Samyama Level 2 1st day. Ninth batch D Samyama 4th day. I'll move to the morning satsang. The Nitya Satsang. Today I'll expand on pain body. Why we human beings keep the pain body alive and continue to suffer with it? In the Inner Awakening, today's session is about pain body. Today, whole day we will be working on completing with all the pain samskaras, pain patterns. See, pain pattern is the expression of root pattern. Root pattern is the root, but pain pattern is the tree. Today we will be working on the tree. Yesterday we worked on the root. Means we poured the acid in the root of suffering. Today we will burn the whole tree of suffering. It's a whole day process, very powerful process, but most extraordinary process I have seen. This two, three process in the Inner Awakening, completing with your biomemory, completing with your fear and death fear, completing with your pain pattern. These sessions literally awaken your whole Kundalini energy and consciousness. Today, we are going to enter into that important session. All the IA participants, please listen. Listen. First thing, pain needs unconsciousness to exist. Listen. Pain needs unconsciousness for its existence. If you are conscious, pain cannot live inside you. If you are conscious, you have to be happy. Nothing can be done about it. If you are unconscious, you have to be in pain. Nothing can be done about it. Pain cannot be driven out of your system by attending to one part of you. If there is a knee pain, you attend to it, it will become stomach pain. If it is a stomach pain now, you give medicine and do what you want, it will become neck pain. If you drive that also out, it will become back pain. If you drive that also out, it will become a headache. If you drive that also out, it will become your wife. But whatever, it will be there in your life. Of course, when I meant wife, I meant spouse. It's not only for women, for men also. But please understand, pain cannot be attended partially. That's the law of life. Pain cannot be attended partially. Please understand, any attempt to attend the pain partially leads to more and more powerlessness. For example, I have seen people, first they try to give medicine to the stomach pain, then when it becomes a back pain, they try to give medicine for that. When it becomes a back pain, they try to, then it moves to the neck pain, then they give medicine for that. After 2-3 years, they start living with the pain. They start living with the pain. It is now almost like they are experienced. Pain became their life and experience. Somebody was asking me, why in Hinduism we pierce the ears of men before marriage? Actually, in Hinduism, traditionally, before marriage, all men should have had their ears pierced and Yajnavivita. Whatever community you may be, you should be given Yajnavivita and the piercing of the ears, shaving the head. Somebody asked me, why men are pierced ears, men's ears are pierced, preparing them for marriage? I said, it is two things. One, they've experienced pain and bought jewelry. So now they are ready for marriage. I know. If you missed, you missed. Unfortunately, we get settled with pain. Please listen. If you settle with pain, you age in such a bad way, pulling, pushing, dragging. I tell you, complete with pain, you will age so gracefully. Aging gracefully should be taught as a mandatory lesson for anybody who has crossed 40. Actually, we should have a clear, the universities, this should become a compulsory education. By the age of 7, 1 year, the child should learn about life and living with completion. By the age of 14, 1 year, the child should learn completely about the next level root patterns. Please understand, the preliminary root pattern will always be based on fear and anxiety. The hanging root patterns, I am giving you an example of banyan tree. If your life is like banyan tree, the root of the banyan tree will always be fear and anxiety. The hanging root of the banyan tree will be the lust. When it starts hanging itself, if you attend and complete it, it will not get grounded and become a one more root pattern. So at the age of 14, child should be taught about this hanging root pattern. See, when the hanging root, if you attend to them immediately, they will not get rooted in the ground. They will not become one more root pattern. But if you don't attend to them properly, if you don't complete with them, they will reach the ground, they will get rooted, and they will become one more root. Lust by its nature cannot be original root pattern. The original root pattern will always be fear and anxiety based. And pain is the leaf. Pain can never be a root pattern. That's the good news. Bad news is, it flourishes from the fear. Understand? I'm explaining the whole science of how you develop your mind without even you being aware of it. At the age of 7, a child should be taught the science of completion. At the age of 14, the child should be taught the science of completion with the hanging root patterns, means the patterns which will be getting developed in the child, the lust pattern. At the age of 21, child should be taught to live with enlightenment, means various relationships, various dimensions of life. I am defining, please understand, having completion in all your dimensions is enlightenment. If you are complete in your health, you are enlightened. If you are complete in your relationships, if you are complete in your integrity, if you are complete with your health, if you are complete with your wealth, if you are complete in all your dimensions of life, you are enlightened. At the age of 21, the child should be taught to live with enlightenment. At the age of 28, the child should be taught the science of enriching. Please listen. At the age of 35, the child should know life has no other purpose than enriching. And at the age of 42, child should be taught to complete with the pains, pain patterns, so that he ages gracefully. And I commit with Veda Mata again, I will make an university where all these programs will be available, like a 3 months, 6 months, 2 years, 1 year, 1 month, like these courses where people can come and get prepared experientially, learn this science to live their life. वी इंडियंस आर सो फूलिश जस्ट फॉर दिस नॉनसेंस क्रिकेट वी हैव बोर्ड्स एंड क्रोर्स ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी इज गेटिंग वेस्टेड. But we don't have university for yoga. It's very recently in Gujarat the first yoga university started. There is one small in Bangalore, but very small. The infrastructure is too small. It is time we create University for Inner Sciences. Completing with the pain helps you to age gracefully. Aging gracefully, I tell you, I always tell all my disciples, when you are young, go wherever you want. Go to any country you want. Go to any state you want. Go anywhere, make money, hold big posts. Go and become judge in US Supreme Court. Go and become head of the Chamber of Commerce in Malaysia. Go and become the top guy in the Wall Street in New York. Go and do whatever you want when you are young. But when you want to retire, come back to your old Indian village. That's the best place to age gracefully. That is the best place to age gracefully. I tell you, come back to your old ancestral village. Relax with the life. This aging gracefully is one of the important thing, very important thing in the human life. Don't live in a place where you worked when you are retiring, after you retire. I tell you, psychologically you cannot handle that place, because now you are directly not useful in their wheel. The attention given to you, the respect given to you, the pride given to you, all will reduce, which your heart cannot handle. For aging gracefully, come back to your rural Indian ancestral village. And I always tell people, to age gracefully, Indian villages are the best places. Indian villages are the best places to age gracefully. Completing with your pain helps you to age gracefully. I have a story about aging gracefully. प्लीज लिसन, द पेन व्हेन यू डोंट कंप्लीट विद द पेन बॉडी यू डू नॉट फील यू लिव्ड. So naturally, aging gracefully does not happen. One lady who is not willing to age gracefully is pushed, and she is almost 70, but spends all the husband's income on lipstick, makeup, the miracle products, age miracle products from head to toe, as many spare parts as possible, as many polishing coats as possible. One day, after emptying the husband's whole salary, means retirement income, with a full makeup, she comes and stands in front of the husband and asks, "Honey, with all this makeup, tell me how I look." He said, "Amazing." He can't tell anything else. He says, "If I just see your hair, you are only 20. If I just see your cheek, it's only 25. If I just see your skin, you are less than 18. If I see your eyes and the lips, less than 20. She was floored and blushing. She said, "Stop, honey, you are too much." He said, wait, dear, I have not counted everything together. I have not added all." So you have to wait till he adds everything. Aging gracefully happens when you complete with pain. Please understand. Completion with the pain body is one of the basic requirement for any adult, which we'll be doing today. When there is an incompletion in your pain body, continuously you will be so agitated the whole day, you will be running here, there. Literally like a headless chicken. I have seen people, they can't live in peace without problem. No, really, they cannot live in peace without problem. Problems are basic requirement for them. Problems should be a basic requirement for them. They cannot live without problems. I tell you, यू डोंट नीड प्रॉब्लम एज योर बेसिक सर्वाइवल नीड. कंप्लीट विथ योर पेन बॉडी. कंप्लीटिंग विथ योर पेन बॉडी विल ब्रिंग सो मच ऑफ फुलफिलमेंट इनसाइड यू. Such joy inside you. When you don't complete with your pain body and leave it, aging will become more and more difficult and complicated. As I said, aging in the downtown New York will be very difficult. Aging the downtown Mumbai will be very difficult. Aging in the downtown Bangalore or Delhi is very difficult. Any country, in the downtown, aging will never be graceful. I have seen some of my own disciples telling, Swamiji, you are talking about makeup. 70 year old ladies, they say, Swamiji, what to do in this country? We have to compete with youngsters. I tell you, the need to compete with youngsters is the most disgrace thing can happen to the elders. In India, I can guarantee, this one we have not given up. The elder is always respected. That is why I am telling you, to age gracefully, come back to Indian village. I have already decided, I am going to age only in Thiruvannamalai. I already bought the land and kept it ready. Now I bought the land far away from the city, because by that time the city will grow. I don't want to be in the center of the city. I want to be in the village. So, far away. Where my Akshardham will be, I have not decided. Where this body will reside forever, I have not decided. But where I will age, I have already decided. Understand. Completing with the pain bodies is almost like completing with all the wounds you created while you have started living with incompletions. Because of the root leaves grow, because of the root pattern, pains grow. You have to complete the root and complete the leaves. Your words are the seeds which puts more and more incompletion in others. So you have to complete even with that. Aaj main dard aur peeda sharir par baat karunga. Aaj in our awakening karyakram mein dard aur peeda sambandhit patterns par हम काम करेंगे. ध्यान दीजिए, मूल विचारधारा अगर मूल है तो दर्द और पीड़ा उस मूल से उत्पन्न हुआ वृक्ष है. ये बहुत ही शक्तिशाली प्रक्रिया है. ये आपकी कुंडलिनी शक्ति और चेतना को बहुत शक्तिशाली रूप से जागृत करेगा. दर्द और पीड़ा को जीवित रहने के लिए अचेतना की मूल आवश्यकता है. यदि आप सचेत अवस्था में है, तब आप में दर्द और पीड़ा जीवित नहीं रख सकता है. ध्यान से सुनिए, आपको सचेत अवस्था में आनंदित रहना अनिवार्य है. सुशोभित रूप से वृद्ध होना आवश्यक है, और ये तभी संभव है जब आप दर्द और पीड़ा के साथ पूर्णत्व लाते हैं. मूल विचारधारा भय और चिंता से संबंधित है. दर्द और पीड़ा कभी मूल विचारधारा नहीं हो सकती है। दर्द और पीड़ा पत्तों के समान है जो बाइक के मूल विचारधारा को प्रोत्साहित करने से उत्पन्न होते हैं। जीवन के सभी पहलुओं के साथ पूर्णत्व लाना ही जीवन मुक्ति है। मैं वेद माता को वचन देता हूँ कि मैं विश्वविद्यालय बनाऊंगा जहाँ इस विज्ञान को अनेकों शिक्षा प्रणालियां द्वारा सिखाया जाएगा। लिसन, allowing the pain body inside you is like allowing the ghost to live inside you. You will not know why you are doing what you are doing. Otherwise, why will you steal in your own house and destroy your future? I have seen people just plan for foolish few hundred rupees, sometime crores, and destroy their great future possibility. Understand, pain body takes away your intelligence. Pain drains your brain. Pain drains your brain. But for some people that problem is not there, because first of all you need to have brain to get drained. All the inner awakening participants, get ready for a powerful session. Today, I request all the devotees and visitors and viewers, everyone, to follow today's Somavara Vrata, means fasting, Monday fasting, which we do for Mahadeva, and do Ajapa Japa of Nityanandeshwara's mantra, Om Hrim Nityanandeshwaraya Namaha. This Monday fasting you can do even if you are less than 18, because it is only one day till sunrise to sunset. It is sunrise to sunset. Anyone can do this fasting. Till sunrise to sunset, you will not have any solid food. I request sincerely everyone to do this Monday fasting. It's like giving holiday to your stomach, so that you are fresh, alive. Monday, naturally, you have to do a lot of work. You are fresh, alive to start your week. You can't be weak to start your week. सुशोभित रूप से वृद्ध होने के लिए अपने भारतीय गांव को वापस आइए। जब आप पीड़ा के साथ पूर्ण नहीं है, आप इतने उत्तेजित होंगे कि आप कभी समस्या के बिना आराम से नहीं रह सकते हैं। अपने मूल विचारधारा और अपने पीड़ा के साथ पूर्णत्व लाना आवश्यक है। सो टुडे इन द इनर अवेकनिंग वी विल कंप्लीट विद अवर पेन बॉडी ऑल द पेन एक्सपीरियंसेस। The essence of today's satsang, your brain, your pain drains your brain and trains to be in more pain. Your pain drains your brain and trains your heart to be in more pain. Your brain, please listen, your pain drains your brain and trains your heart to be in more pain. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.